Namaskar student, today we will going to solve few problem which is based on electric field, dipole moment and charge distribution. So my first problem is problem number 1. 2 point charges QA equals to plus 3 microcoulomb and QB equals to minus 3 microcoulomb are located 20 cm apart in vacuum. What is the electric field at the midpoint O of the line AB joining the two charges? If the negative test charge of magnitude 1.5 into 10 to the power minus 10 coulomb is placed at this point, what is the force experienced by the test charge? So here are two charges plus 3 microcoulomb and this is minus 3 microcoulomb and the distance is 20 cm. So we have to convert this one into meter. Now this is the midpoint, so we have to divide this one, this distance, so 0.1 meter and 0.1 meter. Now we have to calculate electric field strain at the midpoint due to charge QA, this one. So according to the equation, E1 equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 by R square. So we know that the value of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught equals to 9 into 10 to the power 9. And QA equals to 3 into 10 to the power minus 6, this is microcoulomb, we have to convert this one into coulomb. And the distance is 0.1 square. So after calculating this value, we will get this one, 2.7 into 10 to the power 6 Newton per coulomb, which is along OA direction. Next charge, electric field strain due to charge QB. This one is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught QB by R square. So the value of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught equals to 9 into 10 to the power 9 and QB equals to minus 3 microcoulomb. So here this one we have to convert this one into coulomb. So 3 into 10 to the power minus 6. This is electric field. So minus will be omitted. So distance is 0.1 square. So after calculating this value, 2.7 into 10 to the power 6 Newton per coulomb along, this one is along OB. So what is the electric field? So net electric field is what? E equals to E1 plus E2. Here E1 is this one and E2 is this one along OA, along AO and along OB direction. So E1 plus E2 equals to 2.7 into 10 to the power 6. This is the value for E1 and E2 is same. So here we have to calculate this value and the value will be 5.4 into 10 to the power 6 Newton per coulomb, which is along AB. Now next question is what is the force experienced by the test charge? So according to the equation, F equals to Q naught E, where Q naught is the charge of the magnitude, which is 1.5 into 10 to the power 9 coulomb, and we already calculated this value E, so we have to put the value. So here Q naught equals to 1.5 into 10 to the power minus 9 and into 5.4 into 10 to the power 6. After calculating this value, we will get that one, 8.1 into 10 to the power minus 3 Newton. My next question is sum number 2. A system has two charges, QA 2.5 into 10 to the power minus 7 coulomb and QB equals to minus 2.5 into 10 to the power minus 7 coulomb, located at point A 0, 0, 1, minus 15, this one 0, 0, minus 15 and another B equals to 0, 0, plus 15 centimeter respectively. So what is the total charge and electric dipole moment of the system? Here according to the equation, what is dipole moment? We know that P equals to Q into 2L. So first of all, QA is what? This is directed from minus Q to plus Q. So what is QA? QA already given 2.5 into 10 to the power minus 7 coulomb and QB also given minus 2.5 into 10 to the power minus 7 coulomb. So what is the total charge here? QA plus QB. So the net charge will be what? Net charge will be 0. Now 2L, the distance is 2L. 2L means what? 2L means A to B. A to B. So here it is 15 and 15, so 30 centimeter, which is 0.30 meter. We have to convert this centimeter into meter. So here P equals to Q into 2L. So here what is the total value? Q means the, this is not at all a summative value, this is the actual value. So 2.5 into 10 to the power minus 7 coulomb, this is Q, and the distance we have already calculated 0.30 meters. So after calculating this value, we will get 7.5 into 10 to the power minus 7 coulomb centimeter, which is directed along z-axis, negative z-axis, okay, which is directed along negative z-axis. So B2, this is along B2A. Next sum, next problem is an unsolved problem. A particle of mass m and charge minus q enters the region between the two charged plates, initially moving along x-axis with speed vx as shown in figure. The length of plate is L and an uniform electric field E is maintained between the plates. Show that the vertical deflection of the particle of the far edge of the plate is this value. So student, you have to do it by yourself. This is a derivation, small derivation, do it by yourself. Next problem is problem number 4, which is based on previous problem, is problem number 3. Suppose that the particle in above equation is an electron projected with velocity vx equals to 2 into 10 to the power 6 meter per second. If electric field between the plates separated by 0.5 centimeter is 9.1 into 10 to the 10 square newton per coulomb, where will the electron strike the upper plates? This is the value of electron and this is the mass of the electron. So we know that this is the equation, so we have to put the value. This one is y max, okay, we have to take y maximum. So we have to find the value of x. Here x equals to root over 2 my. From this equation we will get the value of x. X equals to root over 2 mi divided by qv into vx. Now we have to put the value. M is already given, y, this one is y, this is 0.5 centimeter. We have to convert this one into meter. And vx already given, this is 2.0 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter per second. Q already given and E already given. So we have to put all the value over there, over this equation, and after that we will calculate this value. And this is the approximate value, 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter, or we have to convert this one into centimeter, which is 1.6 centimeter. This is problem number 5. This is an unsolved problem. An electric dipole with a dipole moment 4 into 10 to the power minus 9 coulomb meter is aligned at 30 degree with the direction of a uniform electric field of magnitude 5 into 10 to the power 4 newton per coulomb. Calculate the magnitude of the torque acting on the dipole. This is an unsolved problem, student, you have to do by yourself. This is problem number 6. The figure shows tracks of three charged particles in the uniform electrostatic field. Give the sign of the three charges. Which particle has the highest charge of charge to mass ratio? So here we know that the positive charge particle is deflected towards the negative charge particle, and obviously negative charge particle deflected to the positive charge, positive plate. So here 1 and 2, this is deflected toward positive plate. So here this 1 and 2, they carry negative charges, and here 3 deflected towards negative plate, so it carry positive charges. So according to the equation, means according to the question, which particle has the highest charge to mass ratio? So we know that this one is for the transfer deflection of the electric field. The equation is y equals to half h square. So where a equals to what? Qe by m, and t equals to x by u. So here we have to put all the value. There is Q is charge, e is electric field, and m is mass, and t equals to x by u. And we have to put all the value, and we will get y, which is proportional to Q by m. So highest charge, which one is the highest charge? Q by m is the highest, which one is the highest charge? The maximum particle, maximum transfer deflection is the maximum for particle number, particle 3. This is the highest charge to the mass ratio. Okay, this is problem number 6. Now this one is problem number 7, which is also an unsolved problem. A conducting sphere of radius 10 cm has an unknown charge. If the electric field 20 cm from the center of sphere is 1.5 into 10 to the power 3 newton per coulomb and points radially inward, what is the net charge on the sphere? Student, read by yourself. This is problem number 8. An infinite line produces an electric field of 9 into 10 to the power 4 newton per coulomb at a distance of 2 cm. Calculate the linear charge density. This is a very, very easy sum. We have to put the equation and after that we will get the value. This is my last problem, and this is problem number 9. An oil drop of 12 excess electrons is held stationary under a constant electric field of 2.55 into 10 to the power 4 newton per coulomb in Millikan's oil drop experiment. The density of the oil is 1.26 gram per centimeter cube. Estimate the radius of the drop. So here G, and this is G, and this is, this one is E. This two already given. So we have to put the value and we will get the answer. This is an unsolved problem. So student, read by yourself. Namaskar student, thank you for watching this video. If you have any problem, please write down and ask me about that.